LaFerrari Aperta, 124 scale. It's only been out for what, about a month now, maybe a little bit longer. Alpha Models very kindly sent me this for review. So here we are. But a very quick look through the box. Not really played attention, or paid, not played attention to really what's in there. But we thought we'll go through today and we'll have a look and see what we get in the box. So nice box art. Doesn't come on the front anymore as standard. This comes in the box. I had to stick them on. And as you can see, stick them on lovely and straight. On the side, we got the schematic blueprint drawing on the car. And on the other side, we got the horrendous colour rendering of it, which I think look awful, but that's by the by. So £150, you can get this from direct from Alpha Models, should you wish. And there's a few stockists around the world as well. But go to the Alpha Model website, you can buy direct from them. So inside is just typical Alpha Models box. You got your instructions, which, as we always say, we say in the loosest sense of the word. We've got two decal sheets with a lot of carbon, so that's going to keep us busy for a while. So we'll pop that to one side out of the way. We've got one bag, two bag, three, four, five, six, seven, some screws, the goodie bag with all the photo etching, and the main resin body as well. So we'll pop all this to one side. Now, when I first looked at this car, I thought this thing looks awfully big. It almost looks out of scale because this car is huge. So I'm not sure what's going on here. So if I compare this to my 24 scale Alpha Aston Martin, which I'm currently working on, for a Ferrari, it's a very big Ferrari. So whether it's like this in real life, I don't know. To me, it just looks a little bit too big. The full build of this will be on the channel soon as well. I'll be on my Patreon first and up on ISM in probably 2 or 3 months. So yeah, I just thought my initial thoughts were it looks rather large. So casting spot on as always. There's a lot of very thin areas on the body where you can literally see through the resin. So you have to be careful there. It's right in the joins underneath that block there. So definitely something to be wary of, because that is definitely going to be a weak point. But other than that, the body looks nicely finished. Panel lines are good. They need a little bit of a rescribe. I can see that. Beautiful shaped car. It really is a pretty looking thing. Definitely going to require a light rescribe just to make those a little bit more pronounced. But overall, the fit and finish of the resin is really good. Good to see that the screen's not deformed like on the 458 we've just done. It all looks good, but yeah, really nice, stereotypical Alpha Mozzel resin. Really good, really well detailed, nice and crisp. Like I say, just the panel lines need widening a touch. Other than that, it looks to be cast absolutely flawlessly. And it is cast resin, because the pore stubs are underneath. And yeah, I can't see any issues there at all. But for me, it just looks big. I've got huge hands, and this thing looks absolutely massive. So if you've got one or you're thinking of getting one, what do you think? Does it look over scale? I don't know. Hard to tell. So there's the body. Body looks good. We've also got the interior and the engine bay, which is all in one big piece. So here we've got nothing to write home about. A little bit of rough resin on top there. A few wisps of flash, but we'll get rid of those with a sander. So yeah, you got your engine bay and the cockpit there as well. So I'm just going to pop that inside here, and then I can wrap the body up and put it safely out of the way rather than worrying. How does this go in? Let's have a little look. Does it go in the back first? It does. There we go. Slots in there, and there's our interior and our back. With it being the spider version, you're gonna have a nice look into that interior as well, which having just recently done the 458, well, I did it a while back, which just recently hit ISM. It's going to be nice to see. We've got the rear diffuser, which is a massive diffuser. We've got the underbelly there with, again, the aero working its way through the back. A bit warped, whether it's meant to be like that. I don't know. I'm assuming it is to fit the body. And then the huge diffuser for the back as well, which I'm assuming a lot of that carbon goes on. So that's very, very cool. It's going to look really aggressive on the back of the model. So very, very cool. And again, flawlessly cast. Some nice detail under there as well. Absolutely stunning, beautiful. Like I say, typical Alpha model quality. In here, like I say, all I've done is gone through this kit and I should have ticked everything off. I have, so I've been through and checked everything's in there. So I have been through the parts, with a very cursory look, but overall, nothing in depth. So here's our seats. They have a hell of a recline on them. Again, nice seats. I'm assuming we've got some inserts for them somewhere. Again, nicely molded. Quite clean. A little bit of a clean up, but I'm guessing there's a back for these. So obviously there's two front seats there, and obviously there's no back seats. Got the door cards. Again, nicely molded. Nice cast resin. We've got the front splitter. And again, real nice detail there with the aero underneath as well. Got the veins there. Looking really good. Then we've got part of the dash. Again, nicely cast. And part of the other dash, the top part. So that must sit on there like that. I do like it when they give you them in two parts because quite often they can be coloured differently top to bottom. So it is quite a nice touch to be able to do that separately and then add it together rather than struggling to mask or brush paint. It is nice to be able to actually detail them separately and then add them together later on. So yeah, really nice there as well. So the seats must have a backing on them. So we'll have a look for those in the other bag in a second. Pop that in there. Right, this one. We've got engine in here. Right, so there's the top of the engine cover. Very, very nice. Some nice detail on there as well. Very, very cool. We've got the wheel stubs there as well. Your typical hubs with the brake caliper locating points on. We've got a steering wheel, which has fell off the sprue. Very nice steering wheel on there. Very, very cool. I like it. And then we've got brake calipers here and here. And then on the actual sprue themselves, or the paw stub. Nicely detailed. Very, very nice. Let me just angle these lights a touch more. Wait, let's just move everything. There we go. Yeah, nicely detailed parts. Brake calipers look absolutely fantastic. We've got the front block that goes in the area where the resin is a bit thin on the front of the car. Again, a little bit of aero in there by the look of it. We've got our brake discs, which do have a bit of flash around the outside. But once you run your finger around, it comes off. It's gone. It's like the lightest flash you've ever seen in your life. But yeah, nice detail there. These have a photo etch on them as well. They're looking good. Very nice. And then we've got more engine components. I'm guessing this is transmission. And again, some really nice surface detail on that. That's looking very, very fine. Very nice. And then I'm guessing it's the lower part of the block. And again, some real nice detail. Absolutely, the cast resin. The way Alpha Model casts this resin, it's just second to none. And it is cast resin because there's the pour stub. So that's where it's been poured. But the surface detail is absolutely phenomenal on that. Look at that. So intricate. Very, very cool. Absolutely superb. Must be pressure poured or whatever it is they do to it, because the detail is just absolutely second to none. It really is astounding. Really is, yeah. By far the best resin you can buy for full resin kits anyway, because quite often they can let themselves down. Look at the likes of that USCP M5 I bought. Well, the kit looks all right. On a whole, the resin, it's nowhere near on par with this. So yeah, beautiful. Really got to commend Alpha Model on their resin. Instructions terrible, resin fantastic. So we've got more, I'm guessing, like engine components, ECUs and whatnot. Again, beautifully cast components. They look absolutely stunning. Fabulous. There we go. We've got a whole host of center lock caps and all sorts of stuff on there. I'm not even going to pretend to know what they are. Again, flawlessly cast. We've got a couple of side, guessing they go underneath the side of the body. Nothing to really look at there, just kind of structural parts. We've got exhausts, steering column, and another bit there. I don't even know what that is. Exhaust, it would be nice to see turn metal. I do like the turn metal exhausts. But again, the resin still looks pretty good. Still looks nice. Got nice detail on the inside. It also probably is better in resin. A little bit of flash. But looking good. I don't know if it'll pick up the detail inside. Just around the edge. Very nice. We've got a wing mirror and another wing mirror. Nice long wing mirrors on this thing. They're huge. Look at the size of those things. Yep. Look like they're off a bus. And then we've got headlights. And center I'm assuming the headlights and center console buttons. I do love these center console buttons that climb up the side like that. They are like super cool. They are very, very, very nice. So one more bag of resin. Then we're on to the clear parts. Which Alpha Models doesn't tend to do as well. But we'll have a look. You never know. We might be pleasantly surprised. And then we've got this little bag of bits in here. Sorry, I just need to tighten my watch up. It's doing my head, and I've got a little bit too loose, and it's moving around on my bloody wrist. There we go. Right, so on here, we have got some ultra fine pieces. Not quite sure what they are, but we'll have a look through the instructions in a bit and see if we can figure out where they go. So there's two of those. We've also got a pedal box. Again, some nice fine detail on there. Very nice. Got a whole row of some sort of, I'm going to guess it's lighting of some sort. Looks very cool as well. We've got some more connector boxes, electrical boxes. Again, looking very cool. Couple more pieces, which again, absolutely no idea what they are, but they're there anyway. We've got a thing. I don't know what it is. No idea, but what it is nicely cast. I'm gonna guess some sort of the part of the engine bay. Then we've got another one of those pieces and what look to be like door handles to me. Interior or exterior. It looks like exterior and interior by the look of it. And again, just flawlessly cast resin. Absolutely flawless. So we'll pop all these. So, as I always said, the most important step in getting Alpha Models, go through the instructions. You'll see where I've used a highlighter and check off every single part. Make sure they're in here. Because in my experience, if you come here 6 months later or a few months later, you can't find it, you're not getting spare parts from Alpha. I have not known anybody get spare parts from Alpha to this day. Even myself, I've had damaged bits. So it's not the best. It's not the best. Right, clear parts. These bits are actually very good. I'm guessing they're rear lights, are they? They're actually very, very nice clear resin. So that's good. Then we've got headlight lenses. Oh, no, they're taillight lenses. And again, quite nice clear resin. Optically, it's actually quite transparent, which is quite nice. Yes, makes a change. And then these little, I'm going to guess they're headlight kind of units. Again, really nice clear resin. Well done. There we go. So, yes, we have good clear parts for once, because quite often, the resin clear parts are not the best. They're actually really good. Right, so we've got screws. So four screws in there for screwing your chassis to your body. Be very careful when you do that. And we've got wheels and tires. So let's have a look at these. See what we've got. So Got nice big rims, nice five spokes, no markings on the tyres, which I really, really wish Alpha Model would do, but it is what it is. Nice cast resin, quality, a little bit of flash on the back of them. Quick go around that with a cotton bud to get rid of all that, so that's good. They're wider on the back to the front, obviously, but the quality is good. Quite nice wheels, actually. Quite like those. Classic five spoke. Alloys. The tire treads are really good as well. Just really wish Alpha Model would put a manufacturer mark on them, but it is what it is, unfortunately. I've asked and asked and asked and asked and asked, and they're not going to by the look of it. So it is what it is. But the wheels look really good. Right then, we'll go for the goodie bag, which is all the photo etch and the decals, smaller decals, like usually metallic markings. Can figure out how to open this thing. We will. There we go. There we are. Right, so we got a small metallic decal sheet. So these are self-adhesive. So what you need to do is, on like the door wing mirrors, they'll just peel off with a pair of tweezers. All these other ones, you want to cut off around the plastic, take the backing off, put the plastic over where you want it, burnish it down, and then peel it off. And they are self-adhesive metallic stickers, as you can see, metallic badges. Very nice. They are very, very good. We've got some brass seatbelts, which we will not be using because I hate them. So we'll use our own fabric seatbelts in those. We've got the name plaque, brake hubs, shifters, paddles, grills, and bits for those bits of resin we had earlier. Again, the photo etch, top quality from Alpha Model. Really, really nice. Very, very nice. We've got another small set there of brake bits, grills, so on and so forth. Really, really nice. And we've got one of all the little tiny bits and bobs. We've got Ferrari logo. It's quite hard to see through the blue. I'll bring it up closer. Loads of tiny bits. Seatbelt buckles, Ferrari prancing horses. There is all sorts in there. And then the big one, which has got the radiator grills, the grills for everything else. I'm going to sneeze. Excuse me. We've got all the grills, number plates, window wipers, the cross drilled carbon disc, I would assume, on this, foot pedals, so on and so forth, on a very nice sheet of PE. And then the windows, which thankfully there's only one main window, the engine bay, headlights, and the rear screen between the engine bay and the cockpit, so they shouldn't be too much drama either. Pardon me for sneezing. So we'll pop that in there. Like so. Come in, you go. There we go. Keep all these bits nice and safe. And then we'll go through the comprehensive decal sheets. So this first one is a huge amount of carbon decals. So we've got everything there from instrument displays, center consoles, looks like pedals, all sorts of carbon, all sorts of tiny decals on there. That is a very, very comprehensive decal sheet, to say the least. Yeah, very cool. All pre-cut carbon decals. These decals are fantastic quality. It's hobby design. Hobby design decals are great, so these will go on no problem at all. In my experience, they tend to fit really well, and to get these in the kit is a massive bonus. I've just had to do all that carbon on that Aston Martin myself, cut it all to shape. It took hours to do. This saves so much time, and every Alpha model should get these. Alpha models, if you're watching, put the pre-cut carbon in every kit. They need them. It makes life so much easier and makes the build so much more enjoyable. Please put these in every single kit. I build a lot of your kits. I've picked up on the floors over the years. And yes, put tire markings on your kit and put carbon decals in every single one. More carbon decals. We've got prancing horses. We've got some trim. I'm guessing it looks like engine base shape. I don't know. We'll have a look in a minute. We've got some carbon cutoff there in case you make a mistake. The wheel logos. All sorts of stuff here. Are they for the seats? It looks like they're for the seats. Very cool. So yeah, absolutely brilliant. Lovely decals. And yes, please, Alpha Model, put these in all your kits. Put these in all your kits. It makes it so much easier and more enjoyable to build them. Now, we've got four sheets of paper. Well, two double-sided. You've got all your parts layout. As I say, first thing for me is always when I get one of these kits, go through this, check off everything's there. I use a green highlighter and just go through and tick off everything all the way down to the screws. That way you know what you've got. On here, you've got, it's a very, very basic assembly guide, and that is all it is. There is nothing more to those seats. That is it. Okay, they're quite a simple seat then, really. These are a very basic build guide. So generally, you'll build all this up, and that will go in one unit. Dashboard will go in first, door cards next, then this will slot in. That's my experience. I've had them before where the door cards have to go through the window, the dashboards have to go through for the front screen. You've just got to figure it out for yourself. And this is one of the letdowns of these kits. These are £150 with some of the worst instructions that come with model kits. They are just a very basic guide on how to build these kits. I still love these kits. I always enjoy building them. They're great fun. They're a nice, quick, easy build as well. They're not a heavy part count. The parts are beautiful. They tend to go together well. But these instructions are one of the major downsides to these kits. They are not instructions. It's a very vague build guide. You will need to test fit everything. I'd recommend before gluing anything in place, like all this engine, all this lower section here will probably fit in just fine. This, I would check all this fits in with this before you glue anything in place, because the times have come to do it and then this slots through the top at the end and you can't get it through and you start breaking things apart. You've got to double check everything. They are brilliant kits. I've enjoyed every one I've done. I must have built about, I've lost track now. It must be, what, coming to 15 of them now. And they're all great fun. But for the price point, these instructions are dire. They really are. Now, they have tried to rectify this by doing build guides, which some of their kits have got. Generally more specific to that kit. And there's not one for everyone, which is a shame. But once you've built one or two, you'll start to get the knowledge of what needs to go on when. Test fitting everything is vital. And just take your time on stuff, especially things like the glass, because they're a very prominent part. The grills, be careful gluing things in place. Take your time with your carbon sheets as well. And I would recommend photocopying those decal sheets. So if you do mess one up, you can photocopy it at scale, cut it out, use your own carbon sheet, and you've already got the template for it. I would recommend doing that as well. Great kit, so just these instructions are pretty dire. So we've got dashboard assembly, the interior assembly of the main engine block, the seats with all the decals on there. As you can see, they're quite busy. The decals on the, the seat belts and the photo etch. We've got interior come together with the engine bay and the intake manifold over the top and this piece. Orbiter PE to go on here, there and everywhere. So everything's differentiated from resin is R, PE is PE and decal is D. So it is quite easy to get. Once you familiarize yourself with these, and as I say, once you've built one or two, they become second nature. You start to really enjoy them then. But until then, like I say, test fit every single part. On here, we've got exterior components. So the rad going in place. You've got all the headlights going in, all the grills, the window wipers, the main screen, the floor pan, all the discs, calipers, the wheels, etc. going in place. There's those pieces, as said, would just go underneath, and they do. And on the back, we've got decals for the carbon, where all the carbon goes. So there's a lot of this, as you can see. And then optional decals. Yeah, as I said, I thought they'd go around there. So depending on what colour you go with, what dictate, it's easy for me to say, which colour decal you'll use on the body. But overall, it doesn't look too bad. It doesn't look overcomplicated. You've got a lot of carboning to do, especially on the interior as well. But it's all pre-cut and it makes life so much easier that it'd be an absolute breeze to do. Loads on the dashboard as well. So this thing is going to look as cool as hell. It's all open top. So you can see right in there. So you see all that carbon on the dash and all the interior. it is going to look absolutely awesome. So there we go. Alpha Models 124 Ferrari LaFerrari Aperta.